Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. This is our first learning module of schizophrenia. So here you can see the term of schizophrenia, which seems to be the multiple spectrum of the disorders. Like schizophrenia is a single term, but the schizophrenia are the various types of multiple disorders which are clustered in a term like schizophrenia. So there are two types of classification systems all over the world. First is the DSM-5, which is known as the Diagnostic Statistical Manual. It's fifth version, and the ICD type of classification, International Classification of Diseases, which is followed by the World Health Organization and the countries which are following this classification system. But the DSM-5 is the American Psychiatric Association who follows this classification system. So schizophrenias are classified in DSM-5 into the paranoid type, disorganized type, catatonic type, undifferentiated type, residual type. So the ICD-10 classification system had the classification of paranoid schizophrenia, epiphrenic schizophrenia or disorganized type, catatonic schizophrenia, undifferentiated schizophrenia, and post-schizophrenic depression. Residual schizophrenia, simple schizophrenia, these are the terms which are used in the ICD-10 classification system. Now we come to the key symptoms of various schizophrenia types. For example, let us see what type of paranoid this schizophrenia is. It contains delusions and hallucinations. That's why it is known as the positive symptom schizophrenia. Epiphrenic or disorganized type of schizophrenia has the disorganized speech and behavior. It has the flat or inappropriate effect. Then the key symptoms of the catatonic schizophrenia are the psychomotor disturbance. Undifferentiated schizophrenia has the general symptoms, and the post-schizophrenic depression is known as some residual symptoms, but depressive picture, these are predominant. So it means that when we treat the schizophrenia, after schizophrenia's symptoms are over, then there are residual symptoms which are mostly depressive in nature, because the person, when he comes to the conclusion that he has been suffering from psychotic illness, so he is so much depressed. Then there are residual type of symptoms. What are these? These are the previous positive symptoms, but these are less marked. These are called the residual symptoms. But negative symptoms are more prominent. So simple type of schizophrenia has the no delusions and no hallucination. If there are no delusions and no hallucinations in a person who is suffering from schizophrenia, this is labeled as simple type of schizophrenia. So in ICD-10 classification, at least one of the following must be present. For example, what is the thought echo insertion, thought insertion, thought withdrawal, and broadcasting? Thought echo means when somebody is thinking about something or some thought, so that is echoed in his brain. So thought insertion means somebody is intruding his own thoughts, putting his own thoughts in the mind of the person. Thought withdrawal means the person says that my thoughts have been withdrawn from my mind. And thought broadcasting means whenever the person thinks about anything that is known by other people. So delusions of control and influence or passivity clearly refer to bodily or limb movements or specific thoughts, actions or sensations, and even the delusional perception. But delusional perception means the perception is normal, means if somebody sees a crown on the spoon, he gives its delusional meaning. He thinks about this crown as he belongs to the crown family or the royal family. The perception is normal, but the significance given to that perception is delusional. Hallucinatory voices giving a running commentary on the patient's behavior or discussing him among themselves are other types of hallucinatory voices coming from some part of the body. So, persistent delusions of other kinds that are culturally inappropriate or implausible, for example, religious, political identity, superhuman powers and ability. So person thinks about that he has the certain religious powers, or he is the president of the United States of America, or he has the superpowers, he is the superhuman being, or he has the Herculean power, so he can do any type of activity, even though he is economically poor, physically having the weakness. He says that I am so much strong that I can fight with anybody, or even the armies. I can conquer the countries and all these things. So, or at least two of the following should be present: persistent hallucinations in any modality, when accompanied by fleeting or half-formed delusions without clear affective content; persistent overvalued ideas are occurring every day for weeks or months on end. So breaks of interpretations in the trains of thought resulting in incoherence or irrelevant speech or neologism. Neologism means the person invents his own words and he gives the specific meanings to those words, and the other people may not know what type of meaning the words have. For example, I had seen a patient who would say she was suffering from schizophrenia, and she was saying that na hum nauman badam khate hain na shala loose rakhte hain, humne confession rakha hua, and what does mean the shala and what does mean the confession, we don't know, nobody knows what does it means. So that is the example of neologism. Although it is a irrelevant speech, sometimes the person is speaking but it is incoherent. So it seems that he is murmuring or she is murmuring subvocally. Or even then the speech cannot be, we cannot get the meanings of the speech, incoherent speech. So then there is catatonic behavior such as excitement, posturing, vexiflexibility, negativism, mutism and stupor. Excitement is self-explanatory. Posturing, somebody, you might have seen certain people who are standing alongside the road and are having standing in the grounds and they are having certain posture for hours and hours. They are maintaining it and they are seeing on the sky toward the unseen objects or something like that, and they persist their posture for hours and hours, even for day, even until they are exhausted. Or vexiflexibility means when you move the limb of the person in a certain posture, even odd posture, the person maintains that posture until and unless he is exhausted. So negativism means anything you ask the person to do, he does quite opposite to that. Mutism is self-explanatory. The person becomes mute. He is not talking to anybody, so he prefers to quiet. And stupor means the person is seeing each and everything. He is vigilant, but he is unable to move. Negative symptoms such as marked apathy, paucity of speech, and blunting are incongruity of emotional responses. An incongruity of emotional responses mean the person having the happy mood, he does not reciprocate it. His thoughts are not according to his emotions. A significant and consistent change in overall quality of some aspects of personal behaviors manifest as loss of interest, aimlessness, idleness, a self-absorbed attitude and social withdrawal. So these are the certain symptoms which can be seen in the schizophrenia patients. So the persons who are suffering from schizophrenia. According to DSM-5 schizophrenia classification, it has certain blocks A, B, C. In A block, characteristics of symptoms, two or more of the following, each present for a significant portion of time during a period of 1 month or less, if successfully treated. So these are the delusions, hallucinations, grossly disorganized speech or behavior, negative symptoms, affective flattening, alogia, or evolution. Only one A symptom is required if delusions are bizarre or hallucination. One A symptom means the block A. And any symptom from block A, these might be the delusions of bizarre or hallucinations consist of a voice keeping up a running commentary on the person's behavior or thoughts, or two more voices conversing with each other. So this is the running commentary type of delusions. So that's the bizarre delusion. The person says that any action he is doing, the people are having the running commentary that he is doing like that, he is now standing, he is sitting, he is lying, he is going to washroom and all these things. So then the B block contains the social or occupational dysfunction, C block contains the duration. The continuous signs of the disturbance persist for at least 6 months. The 6 month period must include at least 1 month of symptoms that meet criteria A. Then we should differentiate it from the other conditions, like for example substance induced psychotic disorder due to general medical condition, mood disorder with psychotic features, it should be differentiated from the schizophrenia, acute transient or brief psychotic episode or disorder, or schizophreniform disorder. These must be differentiated from schizophrenia. Sleep-related disorders, delusional disorder, dementia and delirium, body dysmorphic disorder, and post-traumatic stress disorder. So, pervasive developmental disorder, obsessive-compulsive disorder, hypochondriasis, paranoid personality disorders are the other types of differential diagnosis, so it should be kept in mind. Schizotypal personality disorder, misidentification symptoms, induced or shared psychotic disorder, even anxiety disorder and factitious disorder. So there is a large list of differential diagnosis, so it must be kept in mind. When we talk about the etiological theories, neurochemical abnormality hypothesis are suggested, dopamine overactivity is suggested, glutaminergic hypoactivity, serotonergic hyperactivity, alpha-adrenergic overactivity, and GABA hypoactivity are the major theories which are considered. The neurodevelopmental hypothesis and disconnection hypothesis of the neurons. Other theories are neurodegenerative and abnormality of information processing, meta representation theory of the mind, working memory, neuronal migration of or the language abnormalities. Social theory contains the schizophrenogenic mother theory, marital skew, and schism. Schizophrenogenic mother means the overt message given by the mother is else than the covert message. So that's why the splitting of mind does occur. Then there is marital skew. When the parents are having the favors of their children toward their side, either they are on the side of the father or either they are on the side of the mother, that is called marital skewness. The other term is schism. Schism means splitting. So they are actually, the parents are actually pulling their children toward their side. So father is pulling the children toward him and the mother is pulling the children psychologically toward her. So that is the children minds split, that is called schism. Then there is a degenerative theory. So here you can see the normal adolescent Here we can see that normal adolescents brain is like this, and schizophrenic subjects, they have this type of schizophrenic subjects have this type of activity in their matter. So then there is abnormalities in the PET scan. Here you can observe this is a normal brain and this is a schizophrenic brain. These are the differences. So neurochemical theory, here you can see the dopamine and serotonin and GABA receptors. Then there is chromosomal abnormalities, like chromosome abnormalities in chromosome 3, chromosome 4, chromosome 5 and chromosome 6. So these autosomes have been suggested for the men that is causing the schizophrenia. Schizophrenia gene find surprises scientists. Glitches vary from person to person. So fluorescent deoxyribose glucose PET scan shows this never medicated schizophrenia brain is like this, and this is a normal brain. Here you can see the active areas are shown in red. Here you can see there are no activation in the flow. So here you can see the PET scan of normal versus schizophrenia. So this is the normal brain, left and right, and here you can see the schizophrenic brain on left side and this is on the right side. So again you can see the differences between normal and schizophrenia patients. On the PET scan, abnormality you can judge. Then there are MRIs versus FDG PET scans. Here this is the MRI scans and this is the fluorodeoxyglucose PET scan. If we come to the epidemiology, here you can see the incidence in UK and US is 15 per 100,000 population. Male and female are equally affected. Male tend to have an earlier onset. This is the major difference. The males are having the earlier onset and more severe nature of illness. So prevalence, lifetime risk is 7 to 13 per 1000 population, and quant prevalence is 2 to 5 per 1000 population. If we see the mortality, 10 to 38% of all deaths are due to schizophrenia, and risk is high after first year of presentation. Inheritance is 60 to 80%. So environmental factors do play their role. Complications of pregnancy is the major one. Infections, delayed walking and neurodevelopmental difficulties in children, severe malnutrition of the mother, even maternal influenza. Nowadays there is a havoc of this COVID-19, maternal influenza. If the mother is suffering from flu, it has definite effects on the development of the brain of the child who is developing in trajectory life. So what is the management? So biological, psychological and social management, keeping in view the biopsychosocial model of health and illness, we definitely have the idea that the biological treatments, psychological treatments and the social rehabilitations can be done. So how can we manage? In emergency, we can manage by the regular and history taking and the examination, which might be the general physical examination, systemic and neurological examinations and the mental state examination. Why the GPE, general physical examination, and systemic and neurological examination must be done? Because we want to rule out the physical illnesses first, then we come to the psychiatric illnesses. This is the hierarchy of diagnosis. So investigation should be done. Investigations are again biological investigations, psychological investigations and social investigations. Then we come to the drugs treatment, that is medicinal treatments, for example antipsychotics. Typical antipsychotics are the chlorpromazine and haloperidol. Chlorpromazine nowadays has been withdrawn from the market all over the world. So FDA has banned this chlorpromazine substance. So haloperidol is available, that is having the less type of side effects like this neuroleptic malignant syndrome. Here the prochromazine is notorious to cause the neuroleptic malignant syndrome, but haloperidol is not having this type of side effect. But haloperidol does have its own side effects, that is extrapyramidal symptoms or acute dystonias. Atypical antipsychotics are clozapine, risperidone, clonazepine, quetiapine, aripiprazole, aripiprazole, and such type of drugs. They are sedating ones and they are having the less extrapyramidal side effects and dystonic type of reaction, although they might have small type of these side effects, but this is not the typical side effect of the antipsychotics. Benzodiazepines can be prescribed, but one thing should be kept in mind: if we inject the benzodiazepines to the psychotic patients, it has the paradoxical effect. If the person is suffering from paranoid schizophrenia, he becomes more paranoid, he becomes aggressive, even violent. So that's why it should be sparingly used. The long-acting drug should be prescribed, such as diazepam or clodazepoxide in case of the sleep problems in the psychotic patients. So the person who is suffering from schizophrenia, they do benefit from the benzodiazepine if they are having the sleep problems. Otherwise, atypical antipsychotics have the sedating properties. The sleep is good by the atypical antipsychotics. So psychological interventions are the family therapy and psychoeducation of the person. Cognitive behavior therapy is another therapy. Then there is token economy. This depends upon the operant condition. We give the tokens to the patient if he gives the shows the wanted behavior. So his abnormal behavior can be curtailed by this type of therapy. So then is the social rehabilitation. Social work and housing involvement, role of community and psychiatry. Nurses having the major role in the community psychiatry. So social work and housing involvement can be there for the habilitation as well as the rehabilitation. The person, rehabilitation means the person who has come from the 100% activity toward the lower level. So our motto is to make him up to the mark, up to the standard which he was having previously. It means up to the 100% level, although he may not be 100% as much active as he was. So up to the mark, up to the maximum level, if we can get the person involved in the activities like housing, chores, involvement in the other activities, gardening or something professional with somebody, a professional, and he is a skilled worker, so he can be involved in the skilled movements or the skilled type of activity. Then comes the prognosis. What is the prognosis? Here we see the 1/3 of the patients are suffering from schizophrenia, they recover completely. They have no residual effects. 1/3 with relapsing and remitting course. 1/3 of the patients who are suffering from schizophrenia, they show the relapsing and remitting course. And 1/3, they are definitely having the poor prognosis. But according this nowadays, due to the modern treatment facilities and injectables, these person even get benefit. So even 1/3 of the 1/3, they get the pure benefit from the treatment. So they may recover. 1/3 of these 1/3 can recover completely, and 1/3 of these may have the relapse and remitting course, and 1/3 they have, 1/3 of this 1/3 have the poor prognosis. So this was the prognosis. This was all about the schizophrenias. Anybody who wants to, thank you very much. Even anybody who has the questions in their mind, they can join us in this live activity, even they can question about the various slides or the various topics which we have covered in this slideshow. So thank you very much.